This is an essential video for me to make because I do a lot of different things in World of Warcraft gold making, but where I really specialise versus other goblins is being on all 175 EU and US auction houses. A lot of what I suggest involves jumping between realms, so it's important for you to understand why your gold being on another server may not be a bad thing and how it may actually be a good thing. This, I'm afraid, is going to be a boring talking video, but it's essential for me to do so I can refer back to in future videos. Do you want your gold spread across multiple realms? Firstly, answer yourself these questions. What do you want your gold for? And does it matter if that gold is on another server? We can roughly break up WoW gold makers into four categories. So number one is where I fall and requires the least explanation. We make gold because we enjoy it, and generally we do not really care where it is. Gold to us is like Mythic Plus score or PvP rating to competitive players. It is a number by which we measure success. Players in this category usually care the least about having cross-realm gold. Number two, probably the most common reason people start gold making is to simply pay for their World of Warcraft subscription with in-game gold. There are a lot of reasons that people are after Battle.net bounce, but they all fall into this category. The price of the WoW token is the same across all servers, so it really does not matter where you cash in your token. It is slightly more inconvenient having your gold split up, as you obviously need to be able to purchase a full WoW token on a single realm. But if you're able to take advantage of fantastic gold making opportunities on a different realm that you can't on your own, then surely this slight inconvenience is worth it. Number three, you need gold to buy shiny things. We are talking about mounts, transmog, pets, toys, that sort of stuff. In the majority of cases, these can be used on most characters and go into your collection tab so they can be purchased on any server. In fact, having gold on multiple servers can actually work in your favour here, as you'll be able to buy what you want on whichever realm is the cheapest. Number four, you need gold for general WoW expenses such as consumables and repairs. If this is your only goal with gold making, then obviously having it on another server is fairly useless to you. But if you could invest your gold for a month or two to double it, would you? That could be what you could potentially do with pet arbitrage cross realm before eventually bringing the gold back to your main server. This, of course, is an individual choice, but the point is, even a person who only needs gold on their main server can benefit from bouncing it around realms. If you did want to transfer your gold back to your main realm, then simply just run a battle pet TSM shopping scan. Buy whatever's cheap, like 25% of market value, and transfer them back to your main realm to sell. Even if you sell at 50% market value or even 25% market value, you still have transferred back, probably with just a little bit of profit as well. If you're unsure how all this works, then if you just watch my pet arbitrage video that I've linked in the description below, and that goes through it in a bit more detail. The point is, the main disadvantage of having gold spread across servers can largely be bypassed selling pets. It does take some time, of course, but it can be done. Are there any advantages to having your gold spread out? Let's use the most extreme example I could find to make a point. So you have 100 million gold. Do you want 100 million gold on your main realm? Or do you want 40 million gold on your main realm and 3 million gold on 20 other realms? Once you get over a certain amount of gold on your main realm, say around 30 to 40 million gold, it just becomes a frivolous number. However, having gold on other realms allows you to respond quickly if any opportunities do arise. So I saw this pop up the other day. A range of the Swift Spectral Tiger mount, a mount that is currently worth over 100 million gold, selling on a low population EU realm for 3 million gold. Someone, somewhere, made 100 million gold profit here simply because they had the resources in the right place at the right time. Now, these are all at least a year old, as I don't take screenshots anymore, but you can see some of the things I have managed to pick up quite cheaply simply because I had the gold on standby. I will eventually cover on how best to do this in future videos. My conclusions from this video are simple. There are not many circumstances where gold on other servers cannot be used towards your gold making goals. Even if you only need gold on your main server, if you do not need it immediately, you can take advantage of profitable cross-realm or multi-realm opportunities for profit, such as battle pet arbitrage, and flip it back to your main realm. Most importantly, having gold on a lot of servers allows you to respond to gold making opportunities much faster. I'm sorry for the tedious video, but it was essential for me to put this out before I went too much into multi-realm and cross-realm gold making. Thank you for listening, Goblins, and good luck out there.